is what you would call reasonable.
We could not have foreseen these circumstances, Alistair.
Your mission to Whitechapel was to remain covert. I have received word of numerous casualties and reports of destruction to the London hospital. And now this!
I intend to stand by my word. I alone will assume responsibility for all the consequences that may befall us.
Sebastian, you do understand. There is little I can do to protect you from the wrath of the Lord Chancellor or of the Order.
Your father will see reason. Right now, our concern should be finding the other device before it detonates.
Good night, your assistance. We must all hurry off the ship before things get worse.
Sir Lucan will escort you and see to the evacuation. We must resume our pursuit.
Surely this is a situation for all hands. You do not intend to stay aboard.
We will join you as soon as we can.
Izzy, see to these people, then head to the cockpit.
No, I'm coming with you.
Izzy, you need to find Lafayette and get off this ship.
I...
Your brother charged me to bring you back safely. Do this for me.
We need weapons. There's a guard station nearby. We can avail ourselves of the company's arms.
The rebels will be sending someone to detonate the second explosive.
The rebel leader. She and an accomplice escaped to enact a contingency plan. That must be it.
Agreed. Let's get back to it.
I'll stay here. See if you can get to the weapons hold.
Company rats fleeing their sinking ship. Cowards.
What you need, then we should move on.
The quartermaster has stocked this ship well enough to support a small army.
Company's guard are not known for their subtlety.
I fail to see the benefit in allowing the company to run its own army.
Maybe rebels ahead. Be ready. Get the door. I'll cover you.
All this to keep one there.
The rebels are resorting to bolder methods.
That they are. Something's amiss. This is too bold even for them.
You may be right, but we still must stop them from making things worse. Perceval. Rebels.
Shit!
On my mark.
Knights! Run! You're advancing!
Can't let them...
No!
target!
Sir. I got him! Right here! Cover me!
Rebel neutralized! Clear!
Keep moving! We have to find that second device! Gone through there.
Right, I got it. Here, Chris, can you get through?
I think so.
Look out! One old friend. Too close for comfort. Leave it be! There must be another way. There's no time! Go on without me, I'll find another way through. And don't lose the mark!
Understood. I'm heading to the stern of the ship, and will sweep back towards you.
Hold your fire!
There's no time, Perceval! We have to stop him!
Trust me, Grayson. Listen to me, lad. Stand down.
You have no idea who you're dealing with. We are not the enemy!
Then prove it! Stop this madness.
No. Not as long as the company is allowed to carry on unobstructed.
They won't. We'll see to it.
It's too late.
Sebastian!
Friend. You don't have to do this.
I'm here. Izzy, can you hear me? Shit.
Perceval and Galahad. I need any able-bodied knight in the vicinity of the Crystal Palace to respond.
Izzy.
Milady, no one is believed to have survived the crash.
Gray? Gray, respond. Where the hell are you?
Huh.
do this alone. You two head up to the council.
Gray.
It's all right, is he? I'll join you in time for the succession.
Mes pensées sont avec vous, monsieur.
Condolences. Sir Perceval was a great man. The best of us. I took the liberty of keeping these aside. I know it is not standard protocol.
Grayson. Do not blame yourself for what happened. Let this cloud pass. How can I? He was my mentor. My brother.
So he was. But concern yourself with the upcoming solemnities. The rest can wait.
Too many questions remain, Alistair. I intend to find answers. Mallory's death will be avenged.
Do not fall prey to dark thoughts of retribution. That way madness lies. Come. The Council awaits our presence. Lord Hastings is on his way from the United India House. He wishes to thank you in person for saving his life and the lives of all the other people on the ship. The United India Company owes you a debt of gratitude.
For over six centuries, the knight called Sir Perceval sat with us in Brotherhood. He saw entire kingdoms perish, and others equally transitory take their place. He saw the rise of the half-breeds, and was relentless in their pursuit. To all these things he bore witness, because he was blessed by this. The Grail. The black water that courses through our veins. The bond that unites this order. The elixir which heals all wounds and extends the life of natural men. Yet it cannot ensure immortality. Now, Sebastian Malory, once Sir Perceval, is dead. There is a tradition of bestowing a knighthood in our order. Only on the occasion of the death of him who bears that honor and burden. Generation after generation, new knights have taken the names of their hallowed predecessors. We are assembled here today on just such a solemn occasion. From blood of old. Grail will give new life. Do you, Marie Joseph Paul Yves Rock, Gilbert Dumotier, Marquis de Lafayette, swear to uphold the most noble precepts of our order? Do you pledge to give your life in service to our righteous cause?
With all my heart and soul.
Drink. May the Grail give you life beyond life. By this communion, you are bound to our sacred order. Henceforth, only your blood shall replenish this vial. May the black water serve you well. Always use it wisely. I dub thee Sir Percival, servant of our great king and knight of the Round Table. Rise, Sir Percival, and assume your rightful place at our table. Guards! Remove Sebastian Mallory's body from the council chamber and take him to the crypt. This council is now called to order. Let the terrible tragedy which has befallen us serve as a warning to those who would defy the mandates of this office. The late Sebastian Malory did not perish in the fight against the Halfbreeds. No. He died a victim of his own heedless enterprise and the negligence of those sworn to uphold the highest standards of duty and sacrifice. And to what purpose?
Lord Chancellor, I must have...
Public buildings destroyed! Innocent citizens placed at risk! Incalculable damage done to United India Company property! It is only by the mercy of Providence that an even greater disaster was avoided. All this while not a single rebel was taken into custody. On the contrary, by their rogue actions, the knights in question may have done the enemy a great service.
The Lord Chancellor perhaps speaks too harshly. He would do well to remember that Sir Percival's force did uncover evidence of a rebel effort against the...
Circumstantial evidence! Mere supposition, all of which resulted in a deplorable calamity. I will hear no more of the matter.
With respect, Lord Chancellor.
Sit down, Sir Galahad!
With respect! I, too, have lost a friend. More than a friend. A brother. You do great wrong to sully his name in such a manner.
You dance on the very edge of insubordination, Sir Knight.
I am apprehensive of my responsibility in this affair. Yet if the same circumstances should present themselves, I would do exactly as I have done. As Malory wished.
My lords! Sirs! The rebels have ambushed Lord Hastings' carriage. He and his escort are trapped on the Westminster Bridge.
All knights to arms! Protect Lord Hastings! Let's eliminate these godless rebels once and for all!
Sir Galahad! This matter is not yet over. Someone will yet answer for Sebastian Mallory's death!
Of that you can be sure.
Arm yourselves and take defensive positions on the bridge.
Galahad, your command.
Let's go.
Is
Sir Galahad! The carriage carrying Lord Hastings was hit in the middle of the bridge. We're not sure if anyone's alive.
Lucan and Igraine Perceval, with me.
Hastings may still be alive.
We must reach him.